Hi, thank you for taking the time to spend listening to this webinar. My name is Joe Dena. I'm the Global Business Manager for Defense and Robotics here at Sonardyne. And I'm going to talk to you today about our trusted instruments for mine countermeasure operations. At Sonardyne, we have been providing solutions into the defense space for quite some time now. And these solutions are being used by hydrographers to track underwater equipment. They're used to track divers. We're using them also on dynamic positioning systems for certain vessels, for certain applications. But what I wanted to do today was just specifically focus on our mine countermeasure solutions and give you an overview of our capabilities within this domain, and also some of our instruments and how they fit your mission, and hopefully give you an idea of how we can add value to the mine countermeasures mission. So we'll go through some slides. I hope you enjoy the webinar. And at the end of it, if you have any questions, please don't hesitate to get in touch with us via social media or email or even phone us. Thank you. So mine countermeasures, it's all about this. You know, there's mines out there, and mine countermeasures are a stressful, pretty hard job to carry out. And they're normally done in circumstances where you're always going to be slow, no matter what you try to do. There's somebody out there that wants it done as soon as possible. They want mine countermeasures done yesterday. It's a job that, you know, you can always get it wrong. You can always be late. You can miss one out. You'll never get it right. Doing your job right is just going to be, okay, well, you're just doing what you need to be doing. There's lots of tools out there, conventional mine countermeasure vessels. Use sound variable depth sonars. They can look out pretty far. They do a very good job of modeling the environment and knowing how those systems are going to perform in those environments. And then they would use neutralizers to go and reacquire those mines and dispose of them. But as we move forward in this new environment, those mine countermeasure vessels have become pretty expensive to keep up with. So navies are looking for new solutions. And those solutions often involve the use of unmanned systems or divers or unmanned underwater vehicles and unmanned surface vehicles. And towed fish systems being pulled by them. When you start to look at all those systems working together, you start to look at ways in which you can improve the performance of the systems, and you start to look at ways in you can manage the logistics of working with all those systems. And that's, I think, where Sonardyne come in and can make a significant difference to the way that your mine countermeasure missions are going to be operated. So the next three slides are going to look at specific capabilities that we bring to the fore in the realm of mine countermeasures. So when it comes to capabilities, there's three main capabilities that we offer. We can track, we can communicate, we can navigate, and we can image. So let's just talk about tracking and communications. When it comes to tracking, we offer world-leading acoustic instruments to enable you to know where all your assets are at. That's really important. It's kind of almost like an underwater GPS. The ability to know where all your assets are at is just going to improve your operations. So you can see from the picture, from the surface, we can use the acoustic signals to track any number of targets, from towed systems, which could be sweepers or sonars, from AUVs or autonomous underwater vehicles, also known sometimes among some of us as unmanned underwater vehicles, UUVs, and divers. The difference between us and other systems is that we can also incorporate signals and data with the same acoustic signals that we use to track all these assets. So at the same time that we can create the situational awareness for ourselves for where all our assets are at, we can share that situational awareness picture with our assets, so they get to know where they are at. Why is this important? Knowing where we are subsea is important because as we look for mines, we need to record their position, and at some point we're going to have to go back to those mines and either identify them or actually neutralize them. And in doing that reacquisition, we're going to have to spend time looking for them again. And if we can improve the accuracy of our position, we're going to save time as part of that process. That's really important because, as we said earlier, time is where it's at. If we can do this mission quicker, we're going to be doing this mission better. So by getting a really good reference of position for all our assets, we're improving the time in which we're carrying out our mission. What else can we do? We can navigate. We can use instruments to let the underwater vehicles, AUVs or UUVs, or swimmer delivery systems, and even unmanned surface vehicles and ships in DGPS denied environments, we can use instruments to let them know where they are by virtue of dead reckoning using Doppler velocity locks or altitude heading reference systems, inertial navigation systems, and also depth sensors. But we can bring them all together in what we term hybrid navigation. It's an algorithm that picks and chooses what the best sensors and instruments are for the job to provide you with the best possible navigation solution. We can also bring data from the ultra short baseline acoustic updates to improve that navigation as well. And what that does is it transforms, again, the situational awareness for those platforms that are operating in environments that are often challenging because there might not be GPS if you're subsea, or because you have to travel through some pretty terrible seafloor conditions with very low visibility. Our instruments gather all that data and provide you with the best possible navigation solution to enable you to create the best possible maps. And what that means is you're able to then act on that data more rapidly, quicker. You're not having to search for things because you didn't quite know where they were in the first time. And that's something really important when working with lots of unmanned assets, outboard assets. The logistics become a lot simpler if you can just direct your system to go back to a known position and it can do so with a high degree of certainty. The inertial navigation systems that we have are equal to none. Our highest rated system right now is able to carry out 0.01% error from distance traveled. That's without equal in the industry. This is for typical surveys like a lawnmower button. And that 0.01% per distance traveled would translate into, after 1 kilometer, basically a 10 centimeter error, which is, you know, fantastic. You basically almost like acting with a GPS, even though there's no GPS subsea. And the final capability that we bring into the mix is imaging, the ability to image. So this is the ability for our platforms to generate a vision of what's around them. And we do this best with our multiple aperture sonar, Solstice. This Solstice system is specifically designed to be mounted on a manned portable, unmanned underwater vehicle, and it helps transform the sea floor around it into a map of actionable data. Everything that we see in Solstice is made at a higher resolution across the whole swath of the system. We're talking 100 meters each side. So not only are you able to create a picture of what's around you, but you're able to create a picture that provides you with data that you can then make decisions on. That will improve your probability of detections, it will reduce your probability of false alarms, and it will improve your percentage clearances. And what does that mean? What this means is, as you make your map, you're able to determine if objects in the data are actual mines. And if you can make that determination without getting a false alarm, you're able to then send a diver or a neutralizer into a known quantity. If you make a false statement, if it's not a mine, then you're sending a diver on a dive that he doesn't want to do, or you're sending a neutralizer on a job that it doesn't want to do. That will just spend time, it will eat into your time budget, and it's just not good practice. Solstice gives you better data, enabling you to make better decisions, cutting the false alarms, and improving the probability of detections. You're gonna hunt more, you're gonna hunt better, you're gonna hunt faster. So I said I would talk about the instruments, and I'll try and do so briefly because I don't want this webinar to go on and on. And if you have any specific questions around any of those instruments, just make sure to contact us at any point. But in terms of what we do that's different, what do we do that's different from anybody else? Well, actually, we've spent a lot of time and effort building a body of instruments that are all compatible with each other. So what that means is we have different top sides. We have our micro ranger, our mini ranger, and our ranger 2, which is suitable for different types of platforms. We can fit the micro ranger on a rip, we can fit the mini ranger on a shape of opportunity, and the ranger 2 system can go on the MCM vessel itself. And what that means is, depending on the mission, we can configure our systems to get the best possible performance. It's the same for the beacons that go on the offboard assets. We have very small nano systems that can be mounted on divers. We have modems and beacons that can be mounted on AUVs so that we're able to track them and talk to them. And again, their sizes are different to fit the type of mission that we're trying to work with. That gives you a lot of flexibility. It means you can very quickly design a system for the mission at hand. And when it comes to performance, I mean, we're second to none. Technically, Sonardyne have some of the highest performance kit out there. We're talking 0.1% dilution of precision in range. So like after 1,000 meters, our error is about 1 meter, which is, unfathomable if you think about it. When it comes to navigation systems, we build Doppler velocity locks, we build our Sprint INS system, and the Sprint Nav that combines the Doppler velocity lock, the pressure sensor, the attitude heading reference sensor, and the INS all in a single package. It's a world-beating instrument. It uses really clever algorithms to ensure that we get the best possible aiding from the DVL, from the USVL, from the depth sensor to ensure that we get, the highest possible performance from a commercial system. We also have our NOAA system that can be mounted on unmanned surface vessels. It can also be mounted on manned vessels, the MCM vessel itself. And it's helpful, like I said earlier, for working on those expeditionary missions when you don't know what the seabed might look like, or the seabed might be in a dynamic environment and it might change from one day to the next. And you want to make sure that you're not going to hit parts of that seabed and get tangled. Our Solstice instrument, you can see it there, provides data in two dimensions, but also provides three-dimensional data. The resolution of the imagery is 3 × 3 cm², which is, second to none. That data has been built by the motion compensation. So the result is effective mine clearances across the whole swath. So we have 100 meters and 100 meters, and the sweet spot for our side scan is the whole swath that's been looked at for mine hunting. And that's something important to sort of like look at when considering side scans. A lot of times side scan manufacturers talk about the range, but actually what you should be considering is the effective mine hunting range of that sonar. And fortunately for us, our sonar is able to provide an effective mine hunting range across the whole range of the sonar, which means it enables us to generate a much higher area coverage rate, effective mine hunting area coverage rate. If we're looking at an AUV traveling at 6 knots, we would be able to do 1.6 km² per hour, which for a side scan sonar, it's unreal. We do so also while using very little power, 20 watts. So what that means is we can be mounted on an unmanned underwater vehicle, we can travel, we can do that mission, and we're not making any significant difference. In fact, compared to some other side scan sonars, we're better and we're able to get more endurance from that platform. If you wanted to get higher coverage rates, then you're going to have to change your logistics. Your AUV is going to become a whole lot larger. You're not going to be able to deploy it from a rib. Solstice has been designed for manned portable AUVs. And when that's your platform, you're not going to find a better system. So as I said, I wanted to go through an overview of the capabilities that we provide, touch a little bit on the instruments that we're doing. It's been a little bit of a whirlwind. We don't want to make these webinars too long, but I hope you've enjoyed it. And if you have any questions, I reiterate, you know, we'll be, anybody at Sonar that will be happy to take them. So you can reach us via our usual channels through the website, phone, email, and we'll all be waiting and anxiously waiting to hear from you. Thanks.